mine's worth $100,000. At least that's what SBLI says. Camping, I'll have to bring the mask and fins. Mine's not ringing. Bluetooth headpieces. Because it has a hard time seeing the fingerprint. I shut that feature off on my phone. With me, what's there to worry about?
Oh, well, that's what
she called me back.
She's gonna be able to help.
He's out there with that crazy motherfucker. Thank you. coming back from Marion Harbor, it wasn't even this much of a ripple.
I saw the pictures. I just saw the phone that I just know a lot of times you can't respond on YouTube. Even YouTube, it's like a mirror. People are seeing them. It's a good show. I mean, I hit a light on it, but I think you can see it. Just that you can't say, hey, really cool.
No, there's a place you can comment.
Yeah, but you have to be signed up on YouTube.
Oh, yeah. Amazes me where you can have like ripples like this, and then you get in a section, it's like you're paddling through liquid mercury. It's just like, you know, it's so smooth and just rolls so nicely, you know, there's no peaks or jagged edges or anything. It's just slow, you know. The lottery, I'm going to buy a Mac computer, and then I'm going to buy a real super duper fancy professional video editing software.
You're going to install that in your RV?
Yeah, it's going to be in the RV.
So then you can go wherever you want in the RV.
Yeah. Well, the RV is going to be my house.
Yeah.
I'll go down to Texas and get, you know, make sure my daughter's got a house that's RV friendly.
My brother bought a mini mini and lived in it.
And then I'll register everything in Texas. And then I'll just travel wherever the fuck I want to for the spring, summer, and fall. And then go back to Texas in the winter. No, I'm gonna get a stacker trailer. Stacker trailer is a high trailer. It'll be just as high as a camper. Put your first layer of toys in, then you hit the button and it raises them up, and then you can put the second layer in. So the Harley will go in first, and the kayaks will go in, and they'll get raised up, and then I'm thinking of having a Mini Cooper 3-door for a car. The stacker trailer goes behind the RV. And it's like 20.
So we'll get around this point and cut back around.
Yeah, cut back in and get out of the wind. Yeah, I decided to turn it on, make us.
Okay, my recommendation, let's just do it again. I'll help you
out.
Alright.
Sounds good to me. Showing that like marshy thing. Do I have enough water? Let's see. Yeah, I got enough.
Well, I don't know
Kentucky with a friend of mine picking her daughter up from college. And we took the motorcycle with us. And it was pouring freaking rain the whole time we were out there. We had one day, we're sitting there watching the weather, and there's a break in the weather that was the size of Kentucky.
Oh yeah?
And I'm like looking at this thing going, and I keep, you know, measuring this thing, and I'm going over to the state of Kentucky with it, you know? And I'm looking at it, and she's going, "What are you doing?" I said, "I'm calculating." "Calculating what?" "So we're gonna go to Mammoth Caves on the other side of the state. So I got it mapped out. I know how we're going. So it's all gonna be highway.
Great.
And so we got up that morning and had breakfast. We're just kind of like hanging around watching TV and stuff.
Yeah.
And I looked at her and I says, "At 11 o'clock, get your leathers on." She goes, "What? It's raining." I says, "At 11 o'clock, get your leathers on. I got to get the bike out of the trailer." So I get all suited up, my leathers, go down, get the bike out of the trailer, get it all started up, warmed up. She comes down with the helmets, put the helmets on, went to the gas station, gassed up the bike, went 50 miles north, picked up the Cumberland Parkway, and just shot right across the state at 80 miles an hour. Got to the Mammoth Cave, caught the last tour of the smallest cave, or next to the smallest cave. Then had dinner there at the restaurant, got back on the bike and started coming back. No sooner did I get on the highway, I took a bird hit to the windshield. I thought we were dead. But I gained control of the bike. Had one hell of a shimmy going on. A small one, about
okay.
Left the down feathers in the bracket for the windshield. Yeah, I felt sorry for it. I didn't see it till the last minute, and I was like, "Shit, bang, damn it!"
I got hit by a moose in my house. I was about 30.
Yeah. So if the town campgrounds were ahead of the state ones, that would make that up in there the town.
Okay. Is that a number there?
No.
I mean, both campgrounds are on the other side of that
mountain. Oh, are they? Okay.
Yeah,
so maybe the town one's farther down. The ones we were just exploring are 1 through 10. That's the ones we got the reservation at.
Well, they both have the same number.
Oh, do they?
Yeah.
I like these.
We're close to the water, where we were.
Yeah, well, the sign was saying it was the state, not the town.
Where?
When we beached the kayaks,
yeah.
And I went up to the first site,
the
sign on the post said it was state.
Yeah, right.
So,
state.
Yeah. that's the second time that Earth and Sea hasn't worked for me. I'm gonna have to delete it and reinstall it. Because that one's free.